Hello, everybody. This is Ben Hansen from MinMax. We're a Patreon about games, friends, getting better. What genre is Pokemon Snap? First-person shooter sim? On-rails action puzzle game? Turns out the reason it's so difficult to answer that question is because it taps into a surprisingly deep story about the game's unprecedented and brutal development. In the new book called Ask Iwata, there's a brief section where the late Nintendo CEO Satoru Iwata talks about how Pokemon Snap's development was a rare example in his career of where he got to work really closely on a game with legendary designer Shigeru Miyamoto. They had met years before while working on Famicom Grand Prix 2 3D Hot Rally, which of course we all remember fondly as the hottest 3D rally game of all time. But apparently the collaboration for Pokemon Snap was something special, and it was a quote-unquote notable exception for their career, where they were both deeply involved. According to an old Nintendo interview on 1101.com, it started with the spark of an idea. What if developers from a bunch of different companies joined forces to create something new, something away from the corporate constraints of Nintendo itself? What if there is a development team built without any short-term goals in mind, but one that could take its time and make the most of the Nintendo 64, which was a console that wasn't even out yet? So Iwata and Miyamoto went to the intense president of Nintendo at the time, Hiroshi Yamauchi, and they made their case. And please forgive me for these name pronunciations. After thinking it over, apparently Yamauchi slapped his knee and said, "That's a good idea." He also made Earthbound's creator, Shigesato Itoi, the chairman of this whole committee. So can you imagine Miyamoto here with a nearly finished Super Mario 64 in his pocket, and he's still not content? He needs to plan even harder for the future in his mind to create something entirely new, something completely different from some sort of Pokemon tie-in game, say. So in March 1995, the team put out the call looking for developers to join their quote, Jack and the Beanstalk project, where new talent who thought outside the box could grow just like a gigantic beanstalk. You can actually see a remnant of this team's history with the name Jack and Beans in the intro to Pokemon Snap. They really hit the beans metaphor over the head when looking for new applicants for this job, saying that it was a waste to see so many talents buried in the land of game development, and they have the land for you to grow out to the sky, just like a beanstalk. Quote, "We are not limited to making games in the narrow sense of the word. I don't want people to apply for frivolous reasons such as, quote, a stability in life, or it will help me learn. I am looking for your raw power." And they ended up receiving over 550 applications. Nintendo called it the industry's first publicly recruited, fully independent project team. It's a mouthful. It'd be a self-sustaining team in Tokyo, where the leadership from the committee would occasionally swing by. Miyamoto would travel over from Kyoto every once in a while just to upend the tea table, but by and large, the idea was for this team to work on its own. Miyamoto had heard that developers outside of Nintendo were struggling with the hardware, so this team was an attempt to build something with the magic of Nintendo, except outside of Nintendo's walls, where the sky was the limit for ideas. So what was the actual idea for the game then? Well, it wasn't a Pokemon game since the series didn't even exist yet, and this is where things get a little bit hazy and confusing. The internet largely would have you believe that it was literally a game about Jack and the Beanstalk, but as far as I can tell, that hasn't been confirmed anywhere. People might be conflating the name of the team, the Jack and the Beanstalk Project, and their vision statement of wanting developers to grow up to the skies with the actual content of the game they're working on itself. Why would they assemble this blue sky dream team of game development if you're already chaining them to the world of Jack and the Beanstalk right out of the gate? The most Iwata said was that at this phase of the project, it was, quote, just a normal game where you just took photos. The biggest clue that we have is an interview with the art director for the canceled Earthbound 64, where he says one of the ideas for that game was to use the N64 DD's internal clock to track the growth of beans into plants. And since Earthbound's creator, Itoi, was part of this Jack and the Beanstalk project, maybe this is where that idea originally came from, but we don't know for sure. They were working on the same tech, we know, since early on in the project, Miyamoto wanted them to work on the N64 disk drive so they could technologically leapfrog all competition. Miyamoto said, quote, "There's a tendency to try to make the game more and more like a game. You don't have to do that. Just make something that's on a different playing field from everyone else. We're going to do something that no one has ever done before." And he said the team was constantly questioning, is it going to be fun though? The entire project ended up being a huge lesson about leadership for Iwata and Miyamoto. The whole idea was to build a fiercely independent team, but the founders were frustrated by their paralysis. They kept waiting for natural leaders to step up amongst the developers, but they say that no one ever really did. Iwata says that the new team wasn't really coming together the way they'd hoped. They all kind of felt let down by the next generation of game developers. Even just simple small things, like Iwata being bummed out that he actually had to tell these new developers, hey, you need to be in the office by 10:30 every morning. Given so much freedom, they thought that this office would be filled with developers with fires in their bellies. Basically, they expected an office filled with personalities like Miyamoto and Iwata, not realizing how unique they were and the necessity of structure to kind of mold them into the creative forces that they became. Eventually, Iwata started to second-guess their entire vision, realizing that maybe office structure, direct leadership, and tight deadlines are necessary after all. Iwata said that Miyamoto would say, quote, "It's democracy that's at fault." The idea that with game development, pure studio democracy doesn't really work. Miyamoto said, quote, "It's an excuse used by irresponsible people." Miyamoto even brought legendary designer Tezuka by several times to check out this new team, and Tezuka at least had faith that it would turn out well, even if the rest of Nintendo was skeptical. Because Nintendo HQ wanted this Jack and Beans team to help out with some more conventional projects, to help with the occasional Nintendo release here and there. But Miyamoto insisted, no, this group needs to be secluded. It's magical, it's special, it just needed time. Meanwhile, then, he kept demanding that the team raise their vision for what was possible, rejecting every idea that was seen as too quote-unquote ordinary. Iwata said that all this siloing of the team as something truly special resulted in a lot of suffering. Things were not going well. The new team had never shipped a game before, let alone a cutting-edge Nintendo 64 game. Yamamoto, a designer on the project, said, quote, "I realized after I started that games are created, and then destroyed, and then created, and then destroyed." Miyamoto told them, "It's a game where taking pictures is fun, but the system says you can't take a lot of pictures. And I thought, that's not good. I was saying things that would destroy what they were trying so hard to create." There's a lot of debate about how much freedom the player should have in this photography game. The most popular answer was moderate. But Miyamoto says moderate has no concept. And when it's done, people will say it doesn't have any personality. As the project progressed, Miyamoto said that ultimately, you should have the camera mechanics combined with the freedom of a game like a Super Mario 64. But that this specific team wasn't capable of pulling it off. And even Iwata acknowledged that, yes, quote, "that was a terrible thing to say to them." Miyamoto remained interested only in his big ideas. Quote, "I wanted the Jack project to be a complete bomb. I didn't care if it ended up being a dud. I just wanted them to make something that would surprise everyone when it exploded. For me, the bomb was fine. I was happy with the bomb. I said, let's do it as if we're gonna close the entire team. Let's just go for it." And Iwata says, "So when Mr. Miyamoto said, why don't you just fold it? Of course I couldn't just nod my head, even though I understood why he was feeling that way. I thought, that is just not going to happen to this team." Miyamoto says the team would have thought if they closed it that they finally found a vine to climb up on. Please don't cut this one. So things were pretty dark. Designer Takayuki Machida talks about having a baby boy during the game's development, and he kept coming home in the middle of the night, every night, long after the baby was asleep. There's another designer that said the communication inside the studio was just broken, and he kept waiting for someone just to say, it is over. When an important member of the team had enough and finally quit, Iwata hit his tipping point. He says, "I've developed a lot of software, and I have rarely thought, like in this case, that it just might not work." Then he realized something. There is only one way to make this happen. So he pulled Miyamoto aside and told him the one thing that can make this photography gameplay actually compelling for people. He said, "Miyamoto, I think it's Pokemon. That's what the people want to photograph." Some folks on the team were against the idea, saying it was too limiting and the Pokemon world was too set. They'd have to throw out their own characters at this point. Designer Masanobu Yamamoto eventually came around to the idea, saying that adopting the Pokemon world clarified what we should do and the direction we should head. "And I came to like the Pokemon, so I feel like it saved us." Itoi, on the other hand, says he's thankful that at this point he wasn't more involved creatively with the project, saying, "Pikachu with a picture? I don't think I could have just settled for that." The last 6 months of the game was a sprint. They finally broke down their walls and reached out to other developers for some help finishing this thing off. The team realized that the fun part wasn't just taking the pictures, it was the entire process, like sharing the photos after you printed them out, or having Professor Oak score every picture you took. With the last feature in particular, it finally clicked into place and felt like a real game. And when kids got to playtest it and they were ecstatic about it, the team was finally able to breathe a sigh of relief. So the great blue sky experiment ended up being put on a licensed track. Miyamoto says, quote, "In the end, I was asked to create a game using Pokemon. I don't know if I deviated a little from my original intention. I was happy with a product that was allowed to be rough, but it turned into something very professional." After 3.5 years, everybody just wanted the Jack and the Beanstalk project to be over. Nintendo's attempt at almost like a Valve-style flat studio just wasn't working. Iwata says, "At some point, I realized I had to take down that flag of Jack's philosophy. I should have said, you listen to this person. I regret that." From Miyamoto's point of view, he says, "There are wounds that are healed by selling, right? When I'm producing a game, I sometimes have to be quite strict, but you know what? I've experienced it so many times that when I see that a game sells well, everyone is satisfied. There are people who are very nice during the development period, but I don't want to be a person who is very nice during the development period, but doesn't produce results." In that 1101 interview, Iwata eventually goes on to question what the core motivation is for the three team leads. He says personally for him, it's not really money. Itoi says, quote, "It's the joy of solving things. I wouldn't go so far as to say it's a hormone, but I think it's the most enjoyable part of life. In other words, it's the joy of hitting a target with an arrow, or the joy of getting a girl to take off her underwear, you know. The joy of getting what you want to eat. Once you taste it, you can't get rid of it. Yes, that is a strange Nintendo quote. Pokemon Snap finally released in March of 1999 in Japan, going on to sell millions and millions of copies, and even having an impact on a member of Congress.
I never owned an N64, but I used to go to my cousin's house all the time, and she had Super Mario 64, Pokemon Snap, and probably a handful of other things.
Yes!
And that's probably all I know how to play.
Pokemon Snap was fantastic.
As you probably know, Iwata passed away in 2015. But in his book, Ask Iwata, he says that Pokemon Snap remained one of his closest collaborations with Miyamoto. And despite all the stress and everything they went through, Miyamoto remains amazed that Iwata always treated him, quote, like a prince, and repeatedly told him that he was his number one follower. Miyamoto says, quote, "What makes me sad is that if I have a crazy idea over the weekend, there isn't anybody I can tell about it on Monday morning. When I'm eating lunch, he isn't there to say, I think I figured out your problem, which leaves me feeling stuck sometimes. I really miss him." So, before you write off new Pokemon Snap as just some other Pokemon game, take a second to reflect on how it all started from some of the greatest minds in gaming pushing as hard as they could to try to create something new. And please, for the love of God, if you're watching this and you ever get the chance to talk to Miyamoto, please ask him about the Jack and the Beanstalk project. He hasn't really been asked about it. Meanwhile, the poor folks over at Game Freak have been asked about Pokemon Snap 6,000 times. It wasn't their game, everybody. We'll be covering new Pokemon Snap on the MinMax Show podcast and showing off the very best photos from the MinMax community as well with our show Photo Mode Snap. Thanks to Sarah Podzorski, Merman, and believe it or not, PlayStation's Shuhei Yoshida for help with the translations on this. Really, Shuhei Yoshida, good guy. Just go buy an indie game from PlayStation for him, please. Thanks so much for watching the video, everybody. If you are sick of snark, clickbait, and an avalanche of movie news, you can help support independent games media by subscribing to MinMax's YouTube channel here or checking out the benefits over on Patreon. It's a nice, clean handshake. You support us, and we won't make dumb, condescending stuff for you. Your support helps us continue our mission of focusing on games, friends, and getting better. Patreon.com/MinMax with two N's. We'd appreciate it.